kind of silly, I guess, to have a pencil holder that I'm not using. Keep my fingers from getting sore. All right, keep going. Outline each one of these cells that I painted with gouache. With this Sakura Souffle gel pen. It's like an acrylic ink that has an almost, I guess, dimensional or tactile quality when it dries. And it's a nice sort of shiny contrast to the gouache, which I like. It goes on much darker than it dries. So it looks black, but it'll end up being kind of a nice neutral mid-tone gray. I painted this in these blues and purples. We were driving yesterday and I was looking at this. Oops, see, I can't go back over, even though I just did it. I can't go back over where it's wet because it'll scrape away the paint that is not quite dry. So if I do that, I leave it and I go back. Anyway, we were driving yesterday and I was looking at the sky and how kind of miraculous the color of just a regular old blue sky during the day is. There's so much depth to it. If purples and blues and some pinks even that aren't quite there, but just enough for me to imagine it maybe. Anyway, those colors got into my head and so that's what I wanted to paint with today. So I did paint this earlier over a more boring color I'd done. It was just sort of like, I don't even remember. It was either a super light green. So it was very restful, but a little too restful. I thought it was really boring. All right. When I'm painting this, I was looking over some of my older paintings. The studio tour is coming up in about a week. And so I was looking over some of my older paintings to see if there was something that I could improve upon or change and make it more exciting. So I found a couple pieces. This is one of them. Sometimes I will be more disciplined about, you know, well, sometimes I'll have rules, I guess, about where I'm drawing to kind of make it a little less tedious. So like sometimes I'll say, I'm just gonna do all of the cells that are along the outside. And then once I do that, if I have the whole circle done, then I'll go back in and choose to do all the cells that are surrounded by two or three sides. And then I'll go back around and do the same thing. It just sort of makes it a little less tedious. But then other times, like today, I seem to just be wanting to do whatever. And while I'm over here, I see that there's a little bit of a problem there. So I'm going to, well, I was going to fix it, but I think this might be a slightly different color gray. So I'm going to hold off. I'll see it again. Fix it later. I figure out which color I used for that. I may just end up having to go over the whole thing again with this darker gray, but I might like it. Being a little different. Now I'm definitely gonna go back in and fix the edges here to like frame it a little better. Go over it again with an outline to sort of pop it from the background even more. Oh, my husband's home, so the dogs are gonna start barking. He did say hi, but I told him to be quiet, so that's why he didn't say hello when he came in. All right. It's hard to do these kind of quiet ASMR type videos when you live with other people, but much easier than last year at the same time when we were in the pandemic and so everyone was home all the time. That was really hard to get any quiet at all. But now my daughter's at school. Thank goodness. We're all happier. Okay. All right, so I made it all around, and now, like, if I was going to do this, it would be like, oh, well, I have to color in this one because it's enclosed by two sides or three sides, and then of course the one next to it has to be done, and then of course this one has to be done because rules, and then this one. All right, I'm gonna come back later and get all those parts that are that I missed or that I had to skip because of the wet ink. So now I move on to the next spot. So this one is enclosed by three sides. And this one is by three sides, which means, oh, I don't know. There's nothing over here now. This one, though, is enclosed by three sides. Anyway, you get the picture. So I'll be playing that game for a while. And you're probably going to see a bunch that I'm going to miss. So you can just laugh at me for being unable to see what's right in front of me. But eventually it'll all get done. And sometimes I feel like I run out, so I'll just go ahead and do a line to like meet up with another island of finished pieces. And that'll get me started on another run. Maybe. And then I see a little part that somehow didn't get painted, so I'm just going to cover that by making it into another cell. Rather than getting my paints out again. Oops, alright. The only problem with repainting over old paint is that sometimes you get like a ridge of paint that messes up your line. But that's all right, because that just means that there's more variation, which is always more interesting anyway. Variation in line thickness. And sometimes it's hard to tell. Sometimes the colors are so close, it's hard to tell if it's separate or the same. some up again. Come back later. I'm gonna have to come back and fix that one. Take off all the rough or the sharp edges later because everything around it is wet. So let's hope I remember. Sometimes I will be amazed at what I missed. I think I'm all done and then I'll come back the next day and be a whole section missing. Okay. I had to fix one that was actually up at the gallery once I walked in, and it was glaringly obvious to me. Missing piece. So I came back the next day with a pen and fixed it. Of course, nobody else had noticed it, I guess. Or if they did, they didn't mention it. I do like the headspace that I had to get into for this. Definitely like meditation. The only time it's not fun is when I'm on a deadline. otherwise it's nice to just outline. I've been watching a show on Hulu about restoring old houses in Ireland, which is kind of about the speed I want to be at in my brain for something like this. Some people just fall in love with a building. Can't imagine. Some of the tumble down places that have been just turned into the beautiful homes after a whole lot of money. But it's also nice just to be here in the quiet. You can listen to my dog snore. I read an article, one of those clickbait articles, that said, will your dog love you more if they sleep in bed with you? And of course the article is like, yes, they will. But I just can't. I just can't do it. The small one I can deal with, but not a larger one. I don't think I could. And then they just would make your bed smell bad. And I don't know. I know a lot of people do it. I just think, you know, the little one takes up so much space, even though she's only a foot long. I can't imagine how much space the 40-pound dog would take up. I'd probably end up in the dog bed next to the bed. And everyone would snore. I hope I'm staying in frame. I'm doing my best to be mindful of that because there's nothing more boring than watching a video where all the action is happening off frame. I've done that a couple times. I'm trying to avoid putting my hand on top of the places that it's already wet. So I'm always turning the page so I avoid doing that. But now that I'm over here in this corner, the only stuff to work on is right next to each other. And again, all the places where it's not quite going on correctly, I'll go back and fix. I feel like the pen's getting to the end of its ink. I can still see some in there, but it tends to get like a little thinner or a little less coverage as it gets to the end. Okay, and then like the lines get a little wigglier. All fixable. So now, looks like a lot of them, I think all of them, are done. I'm going to go through and fill in the gaps. And as I do this, of course, I'll be looking for the ones that were surrounded by wet ink, and I'll fill in those sharper edges. Or just fix anything that doesn't look quite right. And these are some spots over here where I pulled up the wet ink with my, by going over it again. Fix all that. There's a spot I didn't get. Thank you. And sometimes the edges just look a little wobbly. I like it to be a little smoother looking. And here's the spot where the pen got a little weird. There's one. Two that didn't get outlined. Thank you. looking pretty good. All right, now I think, let's see, looking pretty good. I'll probably go back later once I see the other things that need to be fixed, like that. Oh. My husband works from home, and so sometimes he wanders around the house on loud phone calls. So I'll probably mute this part out. Okay, as I said before, I need to go now around the outside of this and kind of make it stand up a bit from the background. So I'll just go around the shapes and pop it a little bit, make the outlines a little thicker. I'm trying to avoid putting my hand any place where there's still some wet ink. There's a few little spots. Get rid of some of the wobbles that I'm seeing. Oops, sorry. Didn't mean to startle anybody who fell asleep during this thing. My chair. I just kind of like how this extra thicker outline sort of frames it, differentiates the two spaces, makes the background more backgroundy. Almost done. Here we go. So now what we do is we sit with this for a while. We'll come back to it in a day or two and figure out if I need to outline the outlines or if they are sufficient unto themselves. And I imagine that this one will be hanging for the studio tour. My weekends are the middle two weekends in November. I know West Austin studio tour starts this weekend. I have another week to get ready. So if you want to see the finished one of this, it will be on view. So I'm going to stand up from here, and then I'll probably take a photo of the finished one just so you can kind of see the whole, the entirety of the painting as it stands now, which may be what the final product is. We will see. Thanks for coming along. So here's the final, well, not the final. This is how it looks after I painted on it for an hour, outlining that middle blue dot. So we'll see how I feel about it tomorrow. I think I am going to outline a stronger frame. I kind of like how this outline's not quite as dark as that one, so that probably will remain the same. But for now, I know that I'm going to do the outline on the edges.